Boston Community Church. And Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I like some of the fun Christmas things I'm seeing out there. You guys are like a preview of tomorrow where we have everybody come in their pajamas. Nobody believes me that I show up in my pajamas, but I really do. So welcome to our church, and thank you for joining us on your Christmas Eve. We imagine we'll have some more people joining us over the next few minutes. But we actually set a record at the 5 o'clock service. We had 75 more people than we thought we would have, which was like twice. Yeah, it was a little exciting. So thank you for coming to the 10 o'clock. We appreciate your sanity. I think we'll just do friendlies for a couple more minutes and just give people a chance to relax. Call and response. You might hear some music, but you're still supposed to read your part. But now you need to know who you are so you can read your card. So you'll notice that there's a little line down the middle of the sanctuary. So everybody that's on this side, raise your hand. Excellent. You guys are east. Now we're going to try this side. Yay! You guys are west. So now you know who you are. So throughout the evening during the call and response, you'll be reading the east or the west. I promise I'll help you so you don't have to get lost. And also, there will be three hymns that you'll stand up for. Everything else, all the hymns that we do during the course of the readings, you can just stay seated and relax. But you can stand up for the first one, which is right now. So why don't we rise for O Come All You Faithful. The church has been focusing on the songs that we find in the scriptures that are the Advent songs. And what we hear is that the different people in scripture, some of whom you will hear tonight, actually call back to their Jewish roots for the songs that they paraphrase and that they turn into their own songs. And each song that is sung by a person from the scriptures, whether it is Mary responding to an angel, or Simeon who's caught by an angel in the temple, he's the father of John the Baptist, and he's told that his wife is going to bear him a child, but he doesn't believe it. And guess what happens? He loses his voice. So he goes back out to the temple, so pretend it's Christmas Eve, right? It's a big night, and I show up and I go, that's what happened to Simeon. For 9 months while his wife was bearing his child, he lost his voice and he could not perform his office. And so the song that he sings is sung after his child is born. This is a season of silence and preparation, and it is a season where we hear the songs of people that have had God speak directly to them, or have had a messenger of God disrupt their lives and surprise them and turn everything upside down and say, hey, how would you like to be the father of the Messiah? Or the mother of the Messiah? That's even better. And they say yes, or they say no, or they think, as Simeon did, and come to it over time. But every one of those songs is a song of justice, a song of liberation, a song of expectation that the God that they believe in and that they ultimately say yes to has something to do with the world right now and right here. That something is about to change, and that what is about to change will change their lives, will change the lives of the community around them, will change the lives of future generations. They have called on songs that were from the Psalms for hundreds of years before they sing their songs to God. And tonight what we want to say is that those songs are still being sung. Tonight is the 300th anniversary of the song Joyful, Joyful, Joy the World. That's the joy song we want. 300 years ago it was written by Isaac Watts, who was paraphrasing Psalm 98. But everybody was reading and singing songs out of the Psalter, and it was kind of boring. And he really felt that there could be more life and more meaning to the songs. And so he wrote down this poem as a song. He rewrote a song in his day. And then somebody took a few phrases from Handel's Messiah. You may not even know that, but when we sing Joy to the World, we're actually singing some of the pieces of Handel's Messiah that were put to the words for Joy to the World. And then later, in the next century, it was transcribed over into North America. It became a very popular carol here. But last year was also the 200th anniversary of the song that is the greatest carol that... Wow! This is an exciting thing. That everybody around the world knows. Silent Night. Silent Night was written 200 years ago. And it was written by a priest who himself was an illegitimate son. And he would have stayed on the margins of his town in Austria, except that he was recognized for his musical skill. And he was sent to school, and he became a priest. And he ended up serving a tiny little town in Austria that had been affected by the Napoleonic Wars. It had been decimated by war, by changes in the economy, by changes in health. He served the boatman there. In fact, he got in trouble because he would go and hang out with the boatman at the pub across the street. And he was hanging out with women, which is even worse. Oh my goodness, don't do that. He was getting to know the people that lived there, and they were desperate. And he wrote this little song, Silent Night. But he saved it for 2 years until he had a compatriot who was a great composer. And together, in a few hours, they wrote the song Silent Night, set it to music. And then after a Christmas Eve service, 201 years ago now, with a guitar and their two voices, they sang it. And it was picked up by the Salzburg musical festivals. And it became a very popular carol all around the world, and people didn't even know who had written it. But in both cases, these songs were written to provide hope and resilience in the aftermath of great loss. And the amazing story about Silent Night is that 100 years after it was written, 101 years ago now, on Armistice Day, right? English soldiers heard the German words to a familiar tune being sung across the trenches on Christmas Eve. And everyone put down their guns. And they met in the no man's land between the two sides of World War I. And for a very brief time, for a period of days, they shared stories, cigarettes, music. They sang the carol in two languages. They played soccer. And there was peace. The peace was not forever. But people remember that story, and they remember it as one of the only humane times in an awful time. And if you think that the love and the hope and the joy that we are talking about during Advent is only abstract, let me tell you that the power of music lights up all the different parts of our brains. If you work with people with dementia and Alzheimer's, you know that if you play the song list that they are familiar with, people that have been quiet or absent will come back to life. And for the period of time that they hear the music that is part of their own life story, they will begin to speak to you and share their emotions and become fully present, because music has a way of reaching into the parts of the brain that have been shut off even by disease and bringing it back to life again. The songs of our traditions were claimed by the people that we will hear tonight, but they were ancient even then, and we sing them now, and we are singing them to each other. I can speak to somebody who can't remember the names of their children, and they can sing the songs of joy to the world, the words they know. Let the song of the season land in you. Let it change you. Let it give you light and hope and all the gifts that this season needs. And know that when you sing, you do not sing alone. We come together to sing a song that we have all shared and that is dear to us. That is what this night is about. Love acts in our lives and it wakes us up, and our silence becomes song. And when we leave here, the gift of that song is still in us, and it is yours to carry out into the world and to share with others. Let the songs work in you this evening. Thanks be to God. Alrighty, this is about, you're about to get your big start here. So, let's start with the keys, and hopefully these guys are ready for us.
The reading is the life bulb, but it starts with the east side.
So prophets offered songs as the usual vocal, crying people in lots of their bed.
Isaiah cried out, "The people who walk in darkness have seen a great light."
Prophets sang to the fire of the wilderness, and strength in the midst of suffering and oppression.
Isaiah sang, "Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined."
In Luke, the angel Gabriel said to Mary, "You have found favor with God."
The angel also said, "And now you will conceive and bear a son. They named him Jesus." And Mary said yes to God's challenge and sang with hope and justice.
My soul magnifies the Lord.
The Mighty One has done great things for me. God has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. God has filled the hungry with good things.
Start with the east again.
Oh, no, we're going to still go first. ready for these. Are you guys ready? All right. The prophet Isaiah promised,
"For a child has been born for us, a son given to us.
And he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace."
Sang, "By the tender mercy of our God, the dawn from on high will break upon us, to guide our feet onto the way of peace."
May it tune our lives to a song that begins deep in our hearts and minds, vibrates through our connection to God, and ripples out into our homes, communities, and across all of creation.
Please rise for the next song.
The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid."
The angel said, "You see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
And suddenly,
glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace.
When the angels departed, the shepherds considered what they had seen and heard.
The shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see the baby which the Lord has made known to us."
May we attune ourselves to the gifts from which joy grows: curiosity, gratitude, humor, humility, inspiration, playfulness, and awe.
Thank you.
Tonight, the songs of hope,
peace, joy, and love
celebrate the birth
and rebirth of the Messiah,
the light that comes into the world
and into our lives.
In the Gospel of John, Jesus spoke, saying, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life."
Christ also says, "While you have the light, believe in the light, so that you may become children of the light."
Celebrated anew each year. So on this Christmas Eve, we are offered the chance to be reborn, to carry life's transformative song within us, hope bringing, peace building, joy bearing, love blooming.
You never know what's going to happen in one of these services. It's always surprising. In the last service, somebody read the Christ words twice, so we got that message twice, so it was pretty exciting. So friends, there are many nonprofits that work in this valley, and they help all kinds of people, but sometimes the churches in this valley cover the gaps when other nonprofits are not able to address someone's need. This church, in concert and networked with multiple other churches, does actually address very real needs for families. Right now, we are receiving requests for emergency help with housing, with fuel assistance, with groceries, and with transportation needs. In addition to the work that we do in other parts of the world, we are actually a frontline help for people to keep them in their housing, to keep them at work so that they do not become homeless, so that they are actually able to remain stable and sustainable. What you give tonight goes back out into this valley and into other parts of the world, and it makes a huge difference right now, this week. I've had multiple calls in the last 24 hours for emergency aid. So we appreciate what you do for us this evening. Thank you. Soloist, so I can't remember what's going on tonight. So friends, would you please pray with me as we bless these offerings that you have given this evening. Oh, Holy God, yours is the great song of love that echoes down through generations, and it changes every life that it touches, and it shines and inspires our hearts, minds, and bodies to become the light that is needed in this world. Become a light in our lives that we may be that light for others. Bless us. Bless the offerings that we give to you and the offerings of our bodies and our minds and our hearts, that you may make us the light in the world. Thanks be to God. Amen. Joy to the world, that's our favorite. Almost our favorite. So please rise. We're standing up. Changes when our light is held up together. are the children of light. Tonight, go with the gift of love and light in your lives and share it with others around you. Tonight, when you leave here, we will offer you some little origami stars, a pocket full. Keep one or two, pass them along. Let it be a symbol of all that you can be in this world as you receive the gift of this season. Go in peace. Go in hope. Go in joy. Go in love.
Thank you.